1,160 attended to by Van Muttle, and 1,119 email responses due to the time to their actions. On top of that, to date, just under 6,500 LED units have been installed. Mr. Mayor, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our staff and our contractor, Van Muttle, for pulling out the Scottish staff decisions in the most difficult to their full circumstances. And I think if the members officers, we want a better service than we start, and a lot of local movements get a bit more.
Where there's a hole in the road, no one working. Can you tell me how many licences have been given to the utility companies to dig up gold over the last year? How many have overrun? How many have been fined? If not, why not? And also, can we ask them to work all day, not just 9 to 4? Thank you. Councillor. This is your last question, Councillor.
Thank you,
Councillor. Councillor Mack.
managed to get 15 questions and answers in that one. Hope to improve on that. You should keep them down to two. Okay, that's the question time come to an end. And we'll move on to item 7, matters requiring approval by the council. Councillors, we now turn to item 7 on page 29-22 of the agenda and page 33-76 of the council agenda, the top of which includes recommendations from Cabinet on the 25th of January 2016, Cabinet the 22nd of February 2016, and Cabinet the 7th of March 2016. Firstly, item A on page 31 of the agenda. 7A Cabinet, 25th of January 2016. I now invite Councillor Bill to move the recommendation to approve the pay policy on page 31 to put forward your agenda papers. Is there a seconder? All those in favour of the recommendation with respect to the pay policy, please clearly indicate. Any abstentions? Any against? Carried. 7B Cabinet, 22nd of February 2016, page 47 of the agenda. I now invite Councillor Davies to move with the recommendation in respect to the capital monitoring 2015-16-43 to December 2015, pages 47-56 of your agenda papers. Is there a seconder? All those in favour of recommendation to approve the capital monitoring quarter 3 to December 2015, please clearly indicate. Those against? Any abstentions? That's clearly carried. 7C, we now move on to item 70 on the agenda, enforcement policy scheme of delegation. I now invite Councillor Phil Davies to move the recommendation with respect to the enforcement policy scheme on pages 57-91 of your agenda papers. All those in favour to approve the enforcement policy and delegation, please clearly indicate. Any against? Any abstentions? Clearly carried. 17. I will now invite Councillor Davies to move the recommendation following the meeting of the Cabinet on the 7th of March 2016 to approve the employment and appointment scheme in terms of reference, page 35-42 of your supplement agenda. All those in favour,
I've given notice to officers of a suggested amendment to this, which I'd like to take as an appropriate point under your guidance.
Can I have that amendment moved and seconded?
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
Okay.
I believe the copies are available, Mr. Mayor.
Councillors, I think there's a circulation of this amendment coming round, so we just give a couple of minutes to have a look at this.
Mr. Mayor, potentially while people are looking at it, would be appropriate to say we've got a number of items to be debated. We've certainly got a few, like the lead council and the Labour Party, probably a number. If we're going to go one more, would it be possible for this item to be rather than hold up?
Mr. Mayor, I'm quite happy given the numbers of people present in the gallery for this matter to be debated later on.
Mr. Mayor, can I express my deep concern that we're given an amendment on the night evening of council about this appointment committee? Gives us no time at all to understand the implications of this, to maybe get some input from the head of law and the head of HR. I think at the very least we need an adjournment for us to fully understand the implications of it before we make any decision. But you know, I just think it's
7 of the agenda, I invite Councillor Dates to move the recommendation for an initiative of the panel on the 7th of March 2016 to note the course to be corporate plan management report on pages 43 to 54 of your agenda papers.
So moved.
All those in favour approve the course to be report. Any against? Any abstentions? As agreed and carried. Moving on to item 7F, the agenda. Will councils please note that there is only one amendment I'm aware of which relates to planning committee on page 60 of the sole supplementary papers. This will be on Wednesday the 22nd, not Thursday the 23rd. I call upon Councillor Davies to remove the recommendation following the meeting of the cabinet held on the 7th of March 2016 to approve the draft calendar of meetings for 2016-17 municipal year, pages 55 and 76 of your agenda papers.
So move.
Thank you.
Can I just ask you, Mr. Burr, I have raised this with the Postmaster at various stages around the council diary. My understanding is that it will apply a referendum soon, I think, European referendum form. The mayoral election likely another. So it appears to me that a number of these meetings have been built in into those periods, and how will we ensure that we maintain our appropriate levels of whatever it is, members of.
There is no restriction in council between meetings for various committees and or for it to be conducted business. The issue is the nature of the business that will be conducted, which will determine whether or not there are further implications arising.
Item 10, notice of motions. I am going to move the Girtrell court up to notice of motion first, please. Got a second there? Notice of beginning of two amendments. This notice of motion set out on page 79 of the agenda supplement. First amendment. Councillor Cllr Ann McLachlan formally moved the council. Second. And the second amendment, Councillor Chris Blakey, you now have up to 5 minutes to speak to the notice of motion.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, I think tonight, just asking a question to the council to see the emotion behind the subject. you were spending them there. It's just very part of why we're here and why we are empowered by the electorate to make decisions in an open and transparent way and in a public arena. And most in committees, in cabinets, most importantly in this council chamber. Last week, Mr. Mayor, the Labour members in this chamber voted to a person to allow a budgetary decision that can only be made by council, a decision that will have a massive impact on the most vulnerable people in our care to be made behind closed doors without any means of challenge by this council or the people it affects. Mr. Mayor, I've scoured the council constitution for the relevant pages here with regard to budget procedures, and I simply cannot find anywhere where to say budgetary decisions that can only be made by council can be delegated to a portfolio holder and an officer to be made at a future date in secret behind closed doors.
Behind closed doors. Yeah. give them that choice, the choice they want, Girtrell Court.
I have chosen to sample listen to both the legal council and also to give me the conversation that's happening on the balcony, which everybody else is privy to, and I'm not as a deaf member. So I would ask that the council, please, so I can take part in this full debate as an elected member, that we have a little bit of respect.
Can we please try and have this debate? Otherwise,
are we asking for anything?
We're not going to have the debate, and that would be even more of a tragedy. So, please allow the council as well.
With no debate, you can't pass anything.
Councillor Davis.
So, the range of alternatives in
Thank you.